We're gathering again to prepare to celebrate the birth of a baby. This year in the vicarage, that looks a little bit different because we're literally awaiting the birth of a baby. And hopefully in a few days from now, we'll know something of the joy that that brings. We've already got one daughter. She'll be 2 in January. And we're awaiting the birth of another daughter, due any day now. One of the things I'm looking forward to most is seeing the girls grow up and getting to go to school nativity plays. I went to a nativity play recently and the scene was perfectly set. Mary, Joseph, the shepherds, and then right on cue, enter the wise men. And one of the wise men says to Mary, "That's a nice looking boy you got there. What are you going to call him?" Now Mary, she was stunned. She'd obviously forgotten her lines. So you know what happens in a school play when one of the children forgets their lines? Every teacher in the house rushes to the front row and begins to bow. "The baby's name is Jesus." And suddenly, the penny drops to Mary and she shouts with a loud voice, "The baby! The baby's name is Justin!" And the wise man aghast says, "Justin? That's a stupid name for a baby." Well, Mary was flying 5 years old. She bursts into tears, and her brother, who's a couple of rows back in the school choir, not wanting her to lose face, comes forward and bops the wise man on the nose. And the whole thing descends into chaos. But it was wonderful, because it was real. You know, sometimes we want Christmas to be that perfect Christmas card scene, don't we? But in reality, life is tough and messy. Sometimes it's chaos. And Christmas comes like a highlighter pen, highlighting our joys and magnifying our sorrows. And some of you might be thinking, well, what difference does the birth of a baby 2,000 years ago, 2,000 miles away, make for me in Grosvenor today? Life is tough. I just want to get through it, and I want to begin another year. But let me tell you what difference it makes. Firstly, it makes a difference because it reminds us that no matter what, we are loved. If you forget anything else that I've told you tonight, remember this. The birth of that baby in Bethlehem is God coming among us. God breaking into the human story, into its complexity, into its chaos, sometimes even into its mess, to remind us that we are loved. But the other difference that it makes is this. It reminds us that no matter what we face, we've got to cast iron hope. The baby born in Bethlehem, we're told, was wrapped in swaddling cloth and was laid in a manger. And the Greek word for swaddling cloth is the very same word for the grave clothes in which the man Jesus was laid in a tomb. We're meant to make that link between the child Jesus born in Bethlehem and the man Jesus who walked the way of the cross. The man Jesus who experienced the worst that life can throw at us, even death itself. And because he conquered death and rose again triumphant, he reminded us that love wins, and the best is yet to come. So this Christmas, I pray that you know the gift that God brings, that gift of unconditional love. And whether you're on the mountaintop or down in the valley this Christmas, I pray that you hold on to that incredible hope, a hope that reminds us that love wins, and the best, the very best, is yet to come. And I wish you a very happy, joyful, and wonderful Christmas. And by the way, while you're here, did I mention that we've just had an early Christmas present? We've been working hard on grant applications as a church. We're very grateful to the college for writing us a letter of support. Last week, it was announced that we had our first grant. It's in excess of 300,000, and we're going to do a lot of work to put the church back at the centre of the community. And we hope that when we've done that, it'll be a more comfortable, easier place to showcase the wonderful talents of your incredible students. God bless you all. A very happy Christmas.
Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2, 6, and 7. The people who walk in darkness have seen great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shine. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will be for us.
with me. But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with the Lord. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call him the name Jesus. He will be great, and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father, David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, Son of God. And behold, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month with her, who is called barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." And Mary said, "Behold, I am a servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." The angel departed. you shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in the manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace with will toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels had gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger.
Thank you. 2:1-11. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born the king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and have come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where the Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem in Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time his star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child, and when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. And when they heard him, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were coming to the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. sir.
All right.
Which is excellent. There's a lot of time, isn't there?